please subscribe and don't forget to press the bell icon to get notified whenever we upload a new video.
Hi there, good afternoon. This is Your Stocks. I'm Mangla Malu. With me is Sumaira Abdi. Ho hum for the markets. But remember, individual stocks, they're buzzing and how. Hi, Sumaira.
Let's invite our two experts, Shaina Mukaddam and Sandeep Wagle, join in to answer the queries that are being sent in. And the first query, understandably, is from an investor who holds shares of HCL Tech. Rama Sharma is on the line with us from Andhra Pradesh. Hi, Rama. How can we help you? Okay, I think we're unable to connect with that caller, so I'll just read out the query. Rama has shares in HCL Tech, so bought about 250 shares at the rate of 813 about 2 years ago. He's a long-term investor and wants to know now what he should do with this investment. So, Shaina, let me come to you first on this. He's making quite a bit of money, actually. This quarter, you know, there's some bit of disappointment regards the guidance, etc. But IT as a whole is doing well. Would you recommend that he continue with his two-year-long investment?
Yes, I think he should continue. Because after the sharp rally, we are seeing a bit of correction. But I think the guidance was pretty decent. I mean, while they have factored in the, the latest, the March close rate of rupee dollar, so which has actually to an extent boosted the rupee, the dollar guidance, 10.5 to 11.5 is decent. And I think they're not much affected by any issues regarding visa in the US, at least not much, because a lot, as we have heard the management say, about 60% of their US employees out there are locals. So to that extent, I think the numbers were pretty okay and one can continue holding. I would keep a target of 1,200 and a stop loss of 980.
All right, continue holding with a target of 1,200, stop loss placed at 980. That's the view on HCL Tech. Let's move on to the next one. Then we have Sheikh Altaf calling us from Aurangabad with a query. Sheikh Altaf?
Yes, sir.
Boli aapka sawal.
हाँ सर, मेरे पास 500 एचसीसी के शेयर्स है, लॉन्ग टर्म के लिए लिया हूँ, तो उसकी कैसे है?
अच्छा,
तो रखो या बेचो?
कितने समय तक आप रख सकते हो?
1 year.
ओके, संदीप, एचसीसी फॉर द लॉन्ग टर्म, एटलीस्ट 1 year, व्हाट डू द चार्ट से?
आफ्टरनून मंगलम, आई एम बेरिश ऑन दिस स्टॉक एंड आई डोंट सी the stock sustaining or surviving any bounce beyond 28 to 30, and that is where I would recommend to sell. In case it comes down before that, I would recommend a stop loss of 16. I think the stock has been in a bear trend and I see lower levels coming.
All right, so that's the word on HCC. Sheikh Altaf ji, aapke liye raay yahi hai hamare expert ki ke isme jab bhi aap thoda sa rally dekhe stock mein to aapko isme se nikal jana chahiye. 28 se 30 jo hai wo aapka target hona chahiye, aur agar stock niche ki taraf move kar raha hai to 16 pe aap apna stop loss rakhein. All right, also numbers expected today from Hero Motocorp. Anupama C writes into us ahead of that. She wants to know what's the future of Hero Motocorp for the long term. I don't think she has investment in it already, but perhaps is looking at a fresh investment. Shaina, your thoughts?
Yeah, I would expect decent numbers to come from Hero. So I would take any dips to get into the stock, because I think that, with the recent price increase that they have taken, they would be able to cover their increase in raw material cost. And so I would look at dips to buy. I would keep a target of 4,100 and keep a stop loss of 3,630.
All right, look at dips to buy. That's the word on Hero Motocorp. Sandeep, do you concur? Would you use dips on Hero Motocorp to buy?
Yes, Mangalam. I am also bullish. My view is positive. Can be bought at current levels and maybe some kind of corrections with a stop loss of 3,500. And I would talk of a 4,200, 4,300 target given a time horizon of a year or so.
Now, on the mid-cap index, the mid-cap index has suddenly slipped to the low point of the day. And we have a lot of stocks which are actually hitting low points of today's trading session. Repco Home Finance should come up for you. That one's corrected about 9% from the high point of the day. Remember, on Friday, that's Monday rather, that stock was buzzing. And now it's come in for some bit of profit taking. Cummins, the other stock, that one too should come up for you at the low point of the day. A lot of these consumption names, the likes of Bata, Arvind, Page Industries, all of them have slid to the low point of the day. So we'll keep an eye out on that. The Nifty too is sitting in the green with just about 8 points. So watch out for the frontline index as well as the mid caps. But at this point in time, let's take our viewer callers. We have Yashwant D calling us from Mumbai with a query. Has investments in Orient Paper, Yashwant?
Yes, yes. Orient Paper mein hai mera investment.
Uh-huh.
500 shares hai. ठीक है, तो मैंने लिया था जबकि मतलब ओरिएंट इलेक्ट्रिक मतलब 8 जनवरी को लिया था, तो मतलब ओरिएंट इलेक्ट्रिक भी मुझे, मैं एलिजिबल हूँ उसके लिए. ये कभी तक लिस्ट होगा सर? 171 के प्राइस पे लिया हुआ है.
All right. Incidentally, वो आप यही सवाल हम मैनेजमेंट से भी अभी पूछेंगे, but just keep an eye on the fact that he's not making a big loss or something. He just bought it before it went ex demerger, and right now this is for 42 rupees. The other part is awaiting to be listed. Sandeep, what's your view on Orient Paper, the current listed entity?
Mangalam, the stock is moving pretty sideways, mm-hmm. and I am not bearish per se. I would recommend a hold with a stop loss of 35, and I would still look at a target of anywhere between 55 and 58, talk of the next 6 to 8 months.
All right, so for now, Orient Paper holder. Samrita S. now writes to us from Hyderabad. She says she holds 105 shares in Interglobe Aviation, which she has bought at about 1,100 crores. So good investment working out there. She is a long-term investor and wants to know what she should do at these levels. So Shaina, a couple of things. Interglobe reports earnings this evening. You know, we've seen a very, very sharp spike in aviation fuel prices. Therefore, for somebody who's making a lot of money, is it advisable to at least book some profits right now?
Yeah, I would think so, because one is, of course, the correction has factored in. A lot of correction has already happened with the exit of their chief. But at the same time, I think if you see the impact of prices of the increase in crude on the company's profitability, it may be quite substantial over the next quarter or two. Because if you saw last March quarter, they had an EBITDA margin of 16%, which moved up to 20% if you saw in the last quarter. So the chance of it slipping back to those levels with these high levels of crude is there. So I would book part of my profits and hold it for the long term, because it's a decently valued aviation stock and well funded. So there is no major risk in the stock per se, but for the impact of raw material increase in prices.
All right, no major risk, but for the impact of raw material prices. That's the fundamental call on Interglobe. Sandeep, the chart check on Interglobe would suggest what?
Well, Mangalam, if the view is long-term, then I would hold. I have a target of 1650 plus, and my stop loss would be 1190. But short-term, there can be some choppiness. The stock can go down to 1300, 1280 levels, and on the upside, 1420, 1440 can be a strong resistance.
All right, next query comes in from Nitin Joshi, who writes to us from Nagpur. He has 200 shares in Central Bank at 100 rupees. He's been holding for about 8 months now. He's a short-term investor and wants to know what should be his plan at the moment. Sandeep, your thoughts?
I am not very much happy with the pattern. The pattern for me is negative. I would sell. I would recommend a sell on any bounce in the range of 80 to 85. Don't see the stock crossing 90. And I would, on the downside, keep a stop loss of 66, were that not to happen.
All right. Thanks a lot for that, Sandeep. Let's move on. We have D. Subramaniam. Actually, it's an SMS coming in from D. Subramaniam calling us from Bangalore with a query. And we just need to try and get some more details. Writing to us from Bangalore, holds 200 shares of National Fertilizers for the last 5 months. Wants to know whether to hold or sell. Shaina, NFL, what's your view?
I think you should exit. I see much more downside coming in from here. The company is mainly into urea, and the impact of increase in raw material oil prices is definitely there. And I see a lot of debt on the books. I'm really not too comfortable. So I would give a sell on the stock.
All right. Thanks very much for that. Let's head for a break, but keep your eye on the market, because the Nifty is now back in the red as we speak, and a lot of stocks actually now under pressure. So look at Tata Motors, that's down about 0.8%. In fact, all of that move has actually come off late. Kotak Mahindra Bank is another one which was seeing a near 5.5% rally. So that's shaved off almost 1% in the last few minutes. Titan and a lot of these pharma names, so Dr. Reddy's, Lupin, all of them coming under pressure. And it's not just the frontline space, because even the mid-cap index, which, not so long ago was just down about 150 points, that index has now aggravated its cut. So that's down about 230 points right now. So that's over 1%. And a lot of stocks actually from outside the index now taking a bit of a beating. So you have the likes of Bata, Just Dial, Cummins, PVR, all of those stocks now heading lower into the red. In numbers, a 27% downtick on their top line. In terms of the bottom line as well, they've posted a net loss this time in excess of 7 crores, which compares with the sizable profit in the previous in the same quarter in the previous year, and the stock taking a bit of a hit. We'll get in more details on that operationally as well. The details that are coming through suggest that it's a very, very weak performance. Let's get back to answering our queries. Hemant Rathi now is on the line with us from Rajasthan. Hi, Hemant. How can we help you?
Hello, ma'am. My name is Hemant. I had invested in Reliance Defense.
Okay.
300 shares at the rate of 60 rupees per share.
Okay. Hemant, give me a second. I think the stock he's talking about is Reliance Defense. But go ahead. Tell us.
Hello.
Hi, tell us. Hemant?
Yes.
Go ahead.
Ma'am, I had invested 300 shares at the rate of 60 in Reliance Defense.
Okay, got it.
For a long-term view that Modi is making India, made in India, and defense projects, lot of thought at that time in my mind. But now currently, the price is almost one-third. Should I stay here or should I left out?
Okay, so one correction on my end, the stock he's chosen is correct. That's now 18 rupees. Well, the stock has actually seen a lot of bad days of late, with the auditors themselves raising concerns. Shaina, what would be your take? I mean, he's already made quite a bit of loss. The stock is down to 18 rupees. I mean, should he just bite the bullet?
Renaming the stock by Reliance Naval won't improve the fundamentals. So I think he should get out of the stock. If you see the debt, it is almost, I think, about 5-6 times the net worth. I just don't think he should continue remaining in the stock. While it is good to be in defense, but the thing is, it's not really going to reflect into the numbers for a long time. There are better quality stocks available.
All right. Also a word for the retail investors who are thinking of the defense business and all of that. You know, it's a long gestation business. And Shaina spoke about the fundamentals of the company. Last 2 years, their finance cost has actually exceeded the revenue that the company made as well. And they've never made profits in at least the last 12 years of data that I have before me. So we'll keep an eye out on Reliance Naval, whether it does turn around or not. And it's down 72%. But we have Arul Muruganam calling us from Tamil Nadu with a query. Wants advice on a few stocks. Arul, go ahead.
Hello, ma'am. This is Arul. And I have a general question on the share market. So is this the right time to invest in share market? So it's a general question. And my second question is,